Ken Harris was a good friend of jazz club owner Keith Covington, who's now talking about the night Harris was murdered. Ken Harris, he says, and a female friend stopped by the Haven Lounge to say hello and get a corkscrew around 1:30 in the morning Saturday. While coming out of the bar, Harris and Covington were confronted by masked gunmen. After killing Harris, Covington says the suspects held six club employees hostage while robbing the place of $1,200.
I lost a great friend.
This is the second time since July 8th that someone pointed a gun at Covington's head and robbed his nationally recognized jazz club. Covington and police believe the same people are responsible for both crimes. He believes the suspects are in their mid-20s, medium build, average height, with a limited profanity-laced vocabulary.
Security is a matter of finance.
The night of Harris's murder, Covington says four gunmen surprised him just outside the club door. Police maintain three were there. Covington remembers one of the suspects held a red bandana over part of his face. Investigators say two covered their faces with bandanas. Two of the suspects wore baseball caps. One of them was red. They recovered a black Halloween mask with a white scream face. But unlike the first robbery, Covington thought the bandits seemed disorganized and more nervous. And Covington finds it pretty interesting that they knew how to open the back door considering it was locked, and the security bar, he says, is pretty tricky. Now, we do want to let you know about funeral arrangements for Ken Harris. There is a viewing scheduled for Wednesday. It's going to be from 6 to 8 at the Huber Memorial Church. It's located at 5701 York Road in Baltimore. Another public viewing is scheduled to take place on Thursday from 10 to 11 o'clock at Morgan State University's Murphy Fine Arts Building. That's located on Argonne Drive, and Harris's funeral will follow immediately afterwards. Reporting live here at City Hall, Jennifer Franciati, WBAL-TV 11 News.